Scotty's saying something. What are you saying?
Oh, his little
first time in 25 years without a Valentine.
Oh, Scotty. We'll all be your Valentine.
The 15-Minute Morning Show podcast. Sometimes it's 15, sometimes it isn't. Who's counting? Let's see. Oh, I love it. Scotty's here, but he can't talk to us.
He can
wait. He can wait. And there's Danielle, and there's Gandhi, and there's Nate, and I see Garrett, and there's Scotty B.
Can Scotty hold up like a note, and then we could read it?
Like a hostage?
Yeah.
And
yes.
Yeah, he can. And Scary's here. Hi, Scotty.
What's going on, everybody?
Is that where we need to tell you what's going on? Yes. Everyone, tell Scary what's going on.
What's going on?
Well.
What's news?
Well, you know, we're here doing a podcast.
¿Qué pasa?
In Europe, they take that literally. If you ask someone, hey, what's going on? They will tell you what's going
exactly.
on. Or what's up.
Difference between Europeans and Americans. Here in the United States, if you go, oh my God, we should get together sometime. Doesn't mean you're going to get together.
Right.
In Europe, they take it literally. Okay. Then they'll whip out their phone and go, let's get a date.
Oh, my goodness.
Next Thursday works for me.
They seem to care more in Europe is what I'm
getting
from
this. They do. Yeah. Also, I love you. They feel we toss that phrase around without any consideration whatsoever. You're married to a Brit. You know that.
Let me just tell you. I will say sometimes to Sheldon, I love you. And I know he loves me. But I'll go, hello. And he goes, listen, you know how we think. They don't want to treat it as a beanbag word. They don't just flippantly throw it around. It's not constantly, I love you too. They don't do it like that. It's not how it works. So they say it at the right moment, at the right time. You know, it has a lot more meaning behind it.
And that makes sense. That makes all the sense in the world.
Yeah, it does.
And you would say like, oh my God, I love this coffee. They would never even fathom saying that they love their coffee.
They enjoy it or what? They enjoy it or like
they just.
Rather than tell you they love the coffee, they'll say this coffee has a really great taste. Yeah. This coffee.
I mean, I like that better. That seems more genuine. Yeah,
it is. 100%. It's extremely genuine. And you know, I started learning that when I started going to Europe, years and years and years ago. They always agreed with each other across all of Europe that Americans, we just throw phrases and throw things around without any regard for what we're saying.
Even more so on the West Coast. If you want to be really disingenuous, when I went to go visit Nate, the first time I went to L.A., Nate was working in L.A., he's like, look, you're going to see a lot of people that be like, oh, we're going to do lunch sometimes. Oh. We'll get together. And it's all just a bunch of air fluff, word vomit, which means nothing. And I'm like, really? They don't follow up? Especially out there. Right.
In New York, at least you know where you stand with a New Yorker, typically.
Yeah.
Right. Always.
I saw a whole list of differences, how to spot an American in Europe, and it made me laugh because I was like, you know, we do all
baseball
those things.
Hats.
They said jeans. People in Europe don't just wear jeans
sneakers,
all the time.
Yep. Yeah.
Sneakers. Staring at your phones constantly. Mm-hmm. It really all made us look terrible.
So Gandhi sent a list over to me. The five signs you've reached toxic boss status.
Oh.
Oh.
I'm not saying anything. I'm just saying.
Well, who is our boss technically?
You?
I'm not. No, I'm not. I'm not the boss.
No, he says he's not.
I'm not the boss. I may be the loudest. I'm not the boss.
If it's not you, I guess would that be Tom, Thea?
Bob Pittman?
Yeah, they're all good
people. Do we answer to anybody? What happens around here?
I don't think we do. We don't we don't answer to a higher authority.
Okay.
We're not kosher.
So maybe this just applies to everybody else? I don't know.
So I'm going to get into this tomorrow on the show. I need to read this article a little better. But I'm perusing. It's very, very interesting. There was something else we wanted to bring up. What was that?
Valentine's Day.
Oh, my God.
All right, let's talk about it. Mm-hmm. You know, even in a couple, as I am in a couple, we just Valentine's Day just isn't a thing. It just isn't.
Right.
Yeah.
And I'm sure there are relationships out there where one half of the couple is like into it, the other one isn't. And so it turns into a struggle.
My girlfriend, Robin.
An argument. What do you mean? Okay, let's go with it. Robin wants to be Valentined up, doesn't she?
Oh, my God.
And you don't.
More than any other girlfriend I've ever had in the past, she wants the proper dinner. It's not, gift exchange is a thing, but she wants to do the dinner on the night of Valentine's Day, no matter what day of the week it falls on.
Well,
so I just, listen, I've become accustomed to it because I'm in a relationship with her. And so, sure enough, I got all the plans. I check all the boxes.
No, did you use any of my ideas?
I sure did.
Yes, I'm so excited.
Okay, hold on. So, you really do want to do a good job. You actually went for a consultation with Danielle.
Yes, mm-hmm. Which was a very expensive consultation, might
sorry.
I add.
I'm sorry.
But that's okay.
You're welcome, Robin.
Yeah, anyway, but yeah, so she appreciates that. So she, for whatever reason, that is what's important to her, and I respect that. So we're going to Valentine's it up. I may even wear red.
Oh.
She definitely wear red.
Oh, yeah, wow. Yeah.
They're all in.
Yeah, all in
like
on V-Day.
All red suit.
Oh, wait, Scotty.
Scotty's saying something. What are you saying?
Oh, his little
first time in 25 years without a Valentine.
Oh, Scotty. We'll all be your Valentine.
Scotty, this is your Independence Day, man. This
absolutely.
Is time to celebrate mm-hmm. and live your life.
Exactly. You should be celebrating the fact that you don't have a Valentine this year. Just
yeah.
That
hell
message
yeah.
right there just flooded his DMs, by the way.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I'll be your Valentine.
Yeah.
Wow. What about you, Gandhi? What's Valentine's Day for you?
I don't care about it at all.
Exactly.
Not even a little. I understand why people do. I always sort of thought it was maybe like a new couple thing because you want reasons to celebrate. But I don't care. I know this is cliche, but I don't want someone to do something nice for me because it's a day on a calendar where they're forced to do it. Mm. If you want to do something nice for me because you love me, do it any day of the year. I don't care.
When I was a kid, my dad always used to come home after work with one of those heart-shaped candy boxes.
Yeah.
Every single year. Every single year.
For your mom or for you?
For me.
Oh,
and my mom.
Yeah.
Everyone got Valentine's candies. What about you, Danielle?
So my dad used to do the same thing. And even when I got married, he would drive to my house every Valentine's Day, make sure I had chocolate from him, and he'd drive to my sister. So that's going to make me cry, so hold on.
Oh, Roy.
But
we love you, Roy.
Yeah. We don't, same thing with Gandhi. We kind of like show each other how we feel every day. We never go out on Valentine's Day. We'll go to dinner, but we'll do it the day after or the day before. We just think it's too busy on Valentine's Day, and so we do that. But I always decorate Sheldon's office for Valentine's Day. That's my tradition.
That's
every year I get decorations, and before I leave for work, I decorate his office.
See?
And that's like something that it's like a little tradition that I keep for
you
myself.
You do recognize it then.
Yeah.
That's a really cool thing.
And we give each other like chocolate and tchotchkes, but like I said, it's not like, oh gosh, we have to do something. We have to do this. We don't feel that way.
Yeah.
What about you, Garrett?
Well, we are going out to lunch because, we don't want to pay for a babysitter on Valentine's Day. It's almost like it's like a babysitter holiday where they double charge you.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
They price gouge?
Oh, they price gouge big time.
Holiday pay.
So we're like, all right, let's go to lunch. But lunch is almost just as expensive as Valentine's Day dinner. Where we were shocked. We're like, why are we paying as if we're going out to dinner for lunch with mm-hmm. not even a full menu like that? So we're trying to figure it out. We tried to go this weekend, but this weekend and next, this coming weekend and last weekend, the same thing. The prices are insane for just to go out. So we'll be probably making a heart-shaped pizza or something.
Nice.
Well, anyone in the restaurant business, well, almost anyone in the restaurant business will tell you that they do. They find ways to really cash it in for Valentine's Day. Who wants the filet mignon?
Or they do those damn prefix menus where they force you into like crazy amount of money for stuff that I don't even want to eat, and then they don't even offer you filet mignon. And it's like, oh, you're gonna have the chicken, or I'm like, I don't want chicken for that price. I want filet. Sorry,
God, is that the way you speak at the table? Valentine's dinner?
I don't like the prefix thing. I think that's just a way.
Okay, I gotcha.
Mm-hmm. Well, look,
Well, Elvis. You said about your dad, he got you a Valentine's, and I started thinking, I kind of want to get my son Hudson a Valentine's, but I don't know, because I never got one from my dad, personally. I always got it from my mom, but since I'm up first in the morning, because I leave early, I think I want to do it, but I don't know. I've been on the fence about it.
I don't know.
Do it.
My mom and dad always got me little bags, both of them.
Yeah, here's some candy.
Yeah.
Here.
Yeah, leave him some chocolate or something. Or, some candy.
Get your son all hyped up on sugar.
Leave it for mom. There you go.
And no,
happy Valentine's Day.
Give them some candy in the morning and send them off to school.
Yeah,
exactly.
In school, do they still exchange the little Valentine's
cards?
Yes, do they?
Oh, we did.
But now
did.
A lot of the schools don't let you have like candy or lollipops because you know how some of them had little lollipops. So now it's like you put attach a pencil or an eraser or a rubber bracelet.
But they still have the little cards that says like I choo choo choose you.
Yeah. And they do secret Valentine's. Valentine's, where each student gets someone in the class and they have to do something special for them.
Oh, that sucks, though, if you don't like your person.
Yeah.
See, now that's the thing. Back in the day, you didn't have to give every single kid a Valentine.
Oh, you didn't?
Now you do. Oh, no, not when I was growing up.
No way.
When I was growing up, you had to give every kid
a
Valentine.
No,
everybody
got
one. We did not. I never got any.
I mean, that was a long time ago. I mean, that's back when we have dirt floors in one room in schools.
Oh, my God.
The Brooklyn school system.
But it's even like even invitations to birthday parties. Like, if you're going to invite the kids in front of all the other kids, they want you to invite everybody.
Get the hell
back
out
in
of
the
here.
Day, back in the day, I invited three, four kids.
Thank
and
you,
we
Danielle.
Were done.
It's the school of hard knocks. Yeah. It was like that in Brooklyn as well as in the Bronx.
God, why are you such an? You're like an angry old man today.
Because
look at
me. Give him a filet mignon.
I never got a Valentine growing up.
But it is. I mean, I don't know if it should be the school of hard knocks, but they shouldn't force people to hang out with people they don't want to hang out with. What is that teaching you about the real world?
Oh, exactly.
When you're an adult, you can say, I don't want to hang out with them.
Yeah, but it's just like here. You don't invite people in front of other people.
Of course they do. Have you been here?
Yeah, no, we do click it up a lot.
Yeah. I wouldn't invite someone in front of someone else, but I'd give an invitation to somebody and not invite someone else.
Even though you
in front of them. I don't think you have to invite everyone. You're not going to be invited to everything all the time. That's not how life works.
It doesn't work that way.
You're ruining adulthood.
You have to tell little Bobby and Tracy, don't tell the other kids.
That's the problem. That's where, yeah.
But you're going to Carla's birthday party. Anyway, look, we've done enough. So happy Valentine's Eve.
Yes.
Yay. Have a beautiful day. And let's just love each other. Okay, we'll see you next time. Bye.
Bye.